continuing our discussion about measurements of location and position, let's take a look at the mode. Now, the mode is the observation that has the highest frequency of occurrence in a data set. If we look at the data variables themselves, and if there's a particular data variable that repeats itself more than any other, we say that's the mode. But more often than not, we're working with group data. So when we start talking about group data, we start making reference to the modal class, which is the class that has the highest frequency, the class or category. You know, if you remember correctly, I commonly referred to, or I did refer to, classes as being or having a connection with histograms for interval and ratio data, and the categories for nominal and ordinal data. It's not that big of a deal. It's a class, the modal class, modal category, what have you. Modes are most easily identified by constructing a frequency table and or a histogram or bar graph. Let's take a look at some data. Here's some categorical data. It's not the same exam data we worked with earlier. And here's a partial frequency distribution. When I look at this, I can see that my C's have the highest frequency. There's 11 of them. There's 8 A's, 10 B's, 11 C's, 6 D's, and 5 F's. So if I were to, well, I'd identify this as being the mode. If I were to do a histogram, I can see that the mode is going to be the highest bar up there. There's my mode. It's my C's. Okay, what if I have exam scores that look like this? Again, this is nothing the same exam score data we looked at earlier, so you may want to enter your calculator and fiddle with it a little bit. When I look at this, I can see that my 70 to 80s has the highest frequency, so my 70 to 80 class would be what I identify as the mode. If I did a histogram, the modal class would be this guy, which is my 70 to 80 group. Basically, that's it. That's really all there is to the mode. It's just the individual observation that shows up the most, or the modal class that shows up the most. In the next section, what we're going to do is start talking about measurements of position. We've been dealing with location, which all these location measures talk about where in the number line, if I take a look at my histogram, where in the number line is this thing located? Now I'm going to start talking about position, which means forget where it is in the number line, but relative to the other data values, where is any particular value that we're interested in. That's what we're going to do in the next section.